And you are looking in on Mike Pettine, one of the legendary coaches.
There's Pisciotti, first down and more. Goodbye. There he is, bringing it 20. Pouring it on at the 10, and it's a touchdown. His fifth of the night.
As they count it down for Mike Pettine, got his 300 career win, and now a second consecutive state champion. Don't be surprised if a year from now that these guys have this on their schedule again.
We don't win this game. Our dreams are shattered.
That's a team right there, baby.
Don't celebrate. This is how we gotta play.
Leave it. Leave it. God.
Go out there and beat Army.
It's the purest approach to the game is that you come to the ballpark as a member of the team, ready to play.
I'm like the dinosaur trying to live in a modern age.
It's the season for both of them.
If he feels he's ready to pass the torch, then I'm here ready to take it.
I get the feeling sometimes it's like destiny. Our fans talk about where we're going to go back. We're going to three-peat. That's not the way you play football. Your butts have to make it happen. Make it happen.
High school football, the stakes have gotten higher, especially in a place like this, where you win, 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 and people expect it.
You know, there's nothing magical in the water in the district, but these kids grow up fanatic about playing for CB West because of the tradition that's been built.
You know, I could see if anybody deserves to be ranked up there. I mean, coming off the 2 years that we've had.
Everybody's talking about how good we are. Now, if you start believing that stuff, you're going to be in trouble.
You talk about football is like a family. You cry with these guys, your teammates, you laugh with them. The closer you are, I think the more you're going to pull for one another, you're not going to let one another down. Does this team have that closeness? I don't know yet.
You know, I've been doing this since football-wise, taking up the fall of my life since seventh grade as a kid that went to practice every day on the junior high 100-pound team and played every year in high school, in college, and immediately coached. And have coached ever since 1962. Coaching is teaching. And if you're not teaching kids really essentials of what parents want, and hopefully that's what we're doing other than, you know, winning championships.
Good is not good enough with him, that's for sure. He's demanding. If you don't do it his way, boy, he can get awful angry.
You're the last one out of the huddle. You jog up, get your ass up, and then you don't get down.
Why?
He just.
You're not ready to play.
Everybody keep asking, when do you think he'll retire? When do you think he'll retire?
I know my dad's close to retirement. I don't know when he's going to get out.
But the last 2 years, having played 15 games, by December he was really, truly burned out. Mm-hmm.
You know, if he feels he's ready to pass the torch, then you know, I'm here ready to take it.
As a coach, you know, they've set the standard in our league, and we try to emulate that. I mean, I'll make no secret about it. People say, "Oh, you're so much like CB West," and I'll say, "Thank you very much." I mean, it's a good compliment as you can pay a high school coach. It took me some time, I think, to earn his respect as a coach. I think eventually, you know, after several years of coaching for him, that came. But
strong sack, flip right.
Let's go! Pay attention! I said, dogs a quick end. Flip right on one. Get your head out of your ass.
You know, there's no room for soft touches in our business.
He's asking, well, what is Poppy? Poppy's a football coach. What is Daddy? Daddy's a football coach. And then he'll say, and I be football coach.
You know, I've patterned a lot of what we do here after what I did there.
That was my second game yesterday.
Oh, really?
I was at Pensbury in the afternoon watching my son's game. And then at CB West last night, and the grandkids were at both games too.
I've never seen her, but supposedly she puts her head in her hands.
Really? I just figure if I don't look, nothing bad will happen. So I've missed a lot of exciting plays with that philosophy. And obviously he loves what he does, but he can be very demanding.
We're going to see if there's any difference or if it's the same team that stunk to join out the first half.
He is a perfectionist, so that can be hard to live with sometimes.
Yeah, she's kind of an unsung hero. And Wiley in the background, I think of a coach wants to really make a commitment. And there were a lot of trade-offs. And, of course, she mentioned some of them. I wasn't around as much as I should have been. And then toward the season, you know, mentally you're just in your little zone and you don't, you know, focus on things that maybe you should. And I think that makes it tough for the wife, and that, you know, that they often have to suffer the brunt of the frustration and even the pressure, even when things are going well. You know, how do people deal with pressure?
They yell at their wife. That's what they do.
Come on now. I'm not that bad.
We got this Pachati guy though. He's real good. He's real good.
Drive it hard. Drive it hard. Drive it hard. That's it. Drive your leg. Drive your leg. You do.
I can see it in your eyes. I realize really what's at stake. I mean, you got all this publicity about the two state championships, and like nobody this year has experienced a loss at West. So it's the kind of thing you don't want to happen.
Petten told me today he's up for Gatorade Player of the Year in all the United States. It's down to five guys.
Hi, Dusty. Coach Flaherty, University of Iowa. How you doing, buddy? And I'll call you later.
When Mike showed him to me as a ninth grader, he said, he's a Miami guy.
Man, what's this guy been telling you?
Who's this guy?
Dusty.
Nothing. He don't say nothing.
Well, don't let him bullshit you.
I've been calling him. I call once a week and just said, hey man, what's up, bro?
Not much.
He doesn't like to practice on Mondays.
Is that part of his contract? Holy, what's he squat?
You're dealing with a different breed of cat.
I got you.
If you want to be good at something, you can't snap your fingers. If you want to be good over a long run, you really got to get a formula together and a plan and stick to it.
We start our program in January.
That's football here at West. That's CB West. Not that, Gary.
I mean, in the off season, during the season, there aren't too many teams in the country that work harder than our kids. A lot of that we do as coaches is a tremendous attention to detail.
Mm-hmm. What's supposed to be? One side of it, touching. Up more.
So we challenge our kids.
So what are you doing? Full speed out of control. The sweep, who do you get? You just went and blocked the corner.
Hey, you can't be a nice guy. Football is a tough game. You know, the opponent wants to at times humiliate you, beat you up.
See, this is what I'm talking about. It's the loosey-goosey after the great game. Because your mind isn't on what you got to do.
You can draw the conclusion that, hey, you're abusing these kids. Maybe sometimes we're going over the line, but I think if you take a look at all the players that have gone through our program and the feedback that we get, I think overall we've been on the right track. Now, as I mentioned the other day, the only thing we got so far
this version of City West football is promise. Do you know how many athletes in the world and teams there are that just have promise and never do much? Okay, we've had a lot of teams in the past in City West that had promise and didn't do much. Because they were reading their press clippings, they assumed everything good was going to happen. They forgot what it was that it takes to win.
Oriole on second and one goes to Pichotti off the right side, and Dustin goes in for the score. Fakes inside, keeps it himself, cuts back inside his left tackle, all kinds of running room. 45, 40, 30, 20, 10, 5, and DiGiacomo goes in standing up.
I think it started with the kid, with the trainer said he felt he shouldn't practice. The trainer thought he could practice, but obviously he was upset. He went home. At me, look down on me,
and walk around on me. Yeah, you guys must think that you're hearing the same old song and dance every day. You know, there's a level of frustration growing within the team, the staff, that's something I've never seen before in this program.
And this just goes hand in hand with the way this team is going this year. It's just, it's unlike any team I've been around in 25 years.
Stop walking away from me when I'm talking to you. Get over here.
What?
Where were you? Where were you?
Somebody tripped me up. You told me to go get one. I told you I got 7 reps all week.
You're not going to be a good football team with this type of crap.
You know, we had a meeting and it was just extremely positive. You know, he basically acted like I reacted because of anger, and you know, I thought it over.
They said that in the beginning, me like getting the ball less, which I guess I didn't have a problem with, but I guess I did have a problem with it.
As he said, you know, he was really having some problems with issues and didn't know if he was going to could play or didn't feel like playing. And
you know, he's very driven by statistics, and I'm going to tell you, it's not unlike a lot of good players.
I mean, I like having good stats and stuff. I mean, at the beginning of the season, I didn't think I was getting the carries I should be.
Early on, they're keying on you. Don't be surprised if I don't get you into it gradually, you know what I mean? Don't just be going on to get your 15. And anything after that is dreaming.
I guess they could say I don't like him. Most of the time, I don't like him. I respect him, coach was. I mean, that's all I need, really.
You were coaching there too, huh?
Yeah.
You don't have the headaches, believe me. I could enjoy part of this a whole lot, but the headaches are getting to, you know, it's like the scale that tips. Mm-hmm. And it's tipping in favor of a lot of golf.
We ready, guys?
Yeah!
You know, if you want to see what motivates most football players in their careers, it's when they've been benched.
Until I die, filling with tension, the set dimension. I'm on the earth, the wind.
dog.
That's number two. Move up. Move up. The biscuits slip when the night is over. We shake the whole place. Make the same way.
I gotta look good though.
1,000 in bellies if they don't come off. You can take that to the bank. Okay. Why do we have to get into this all the time? I told you, so long as you're with a school function. Now, you know, if you want to challenge me at every turn, it's going to. I'm like a dinosaur. Trying to live in a modern age, I guess.
Ryan, who's going to win the game, North Penn or CB West?
That's not a leading question.
I always sit on the west side, and our family kind of divides. Half sit on the North Penn side, and the rest of us sit on the west side.
I'll be all right after the game, one way or another, so long as I get a hug from the little ones there.
I was going to say, that's they right. will always run to you, whether you win or you lose.
It puts it in
hopefully it's because we win. I think back and say, why wasn't it this good the first time around? Who's going to win a game?
Yes.
You got it right.
Well, he used to go with his dad to practice. He'd travel on the bus with them. When he got big enough, he was a ball boy, and so he was exposed to football from a very early age and always wanted to be a part of it.
Michael's his son, and he loves his son dearly.
Usually, fathers are tougher on their sons when they coach them than the other players. They don't want to show favorites. And I think you're more inclined to take out a frustration on someone that's a family member versus someone who isn't. I was especially a tough one. You know, if I had to do it over again, I'd take a different approach.
A few things withstanding, like to raise my kids pretty much the same way. I had to qualify.
Not too many trips to the woodshed.
There you go, Pichotti. What kind of bull crap is that? You're closing down when there's no need to close down.
Over here, Servi. Shake the rust off.
What's the... Beep, 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 beep.
You know, putting you on that guy is like sending a poodle after a German Shepherd.
Okay, Clay, run it again. You didn't set your feet, you threw it off your back foot, and then you give me that stupid look. If that's wide open and you overthrow it, you better go for the damn nearest exit.
You try and pretend like it's just another game, but it really, it's the season for both of them.
Yeah, it was funny. Junior called me up today, and he said to me, here's your starting lineup, and he started naming guys. He named exactly who was going to start. He was trying to play little mind games with me.
Tonight is the game of the year. Many people saying the game of the century, even a few, the game of the millennium. It's North Bend, Central Bucks West. It's for all the marbles. The big game of the state this year. They're coming from everywhere. New York, West Virginia, all over.
Now, I've had some alumni come in and tell me, I watch your team this year. You don't seem to have a lot of guys that really want to mix it up. And West football lives on mixing it up.
Well, basically, to call this game a big game is a major understatement. Tonight's battle is a battle between two of Pennsylvania's football superpowers. Both undefeated teams going for a league title, father versus son. The subplots are almost endless in this one. Everyone is talking about this game.
It is a high, short kick, and it will be taken by Aaron Thomas at about the 25-yard line. Cuts to his left side.
All right, let's run an eye blast at the suckers. Here we go. I want power left, rival left.
Again, the power eye look. And it's a keeper rolling. Look at him in wide, wide open. It's Ted Ginnon. And it's a touchdown. Take him out. And it is a hand up. Pichotti's at five. He's in. Touchdown. Dustin Pichotti.
We're kicking their ass. We're kicking their ass.
And the Bucks go out to a 13-0 lead.
Take it, Jack. Come on. Come on. When you see 91, get your ass up there.
I'll tell you what. Kukla's still down. He took a shot after he threw that ball. I know Mike Pettine Jr. is holding his breath right now.
And that will end the half.
My great defense. You got to keep it up. Now, we got the ball in the second half. We can break their backs with another score. Now, you played a great first half. How much do you want in the second half? You wanted a lot.
So back to pass off play action. Got a lot of time. Throws the ball deep. He's got a man down. Second and goal at the 5-yard. Takes the ball and a keeper. He's to the three. He's in. Touchdown. Hand up goes to Pichotti. He's got five. He's got six. He's got seven. He's got ten. Oh, Dustin Pichotti with a great run. Oh, Dustin Pichotti was stopped. He was stopped there. And Pichotti makes it happen. He gets the ball close. Yeah, he's got the first down. Tonight, they have been hitting, hitting, hitting. This game has lived up to every bit of the hype.
23, 5, 3, 4,
and melt the clock.
6, 7,
and melt the clock. 7:45 to go in regulation.
Do what they do best.
Hopefully we'll take care of business in a couple of weeks.
All right, just win the next one, all right?
It's probably bittersweet.
Junior said something about it's a rematch in 2 weeks.
So when I could finally get to him and just hug him and tell him that I loved him and he played a great game and I was really proud of him, he was a little choked up, and I was, I guess, because I was it. But he just hugged me really tight, and I could just feel the pain that he was feeling, and that just took the joy out of the win for me. I was so high 1 minute, and then just...
just think we'll probably be a little looser this time. We'll definitely be the clear-cut underdog. So we'll really, I think the pressure will be on them. We have nothing to lose.
We've heard that before, right?
We have nothing to lose. It's like every team that plays us, we have nothing to lose.
I got a trip to Hawaii for Pichotti, starting Thursday night. 3 days, four nights. All expenses paid.
All right, could we send Mikey with him?
Oh, sure.
No.
All right, this is the road to Hershey. This is the District 1 final.
Straight set up, jet left, 37 pitch.
That's it. I mean, how do I feel? I feel relieved. Well, I'm just relieved that I know it's time, and I've always said that you should never hang around for the wrong reasons. Coaching, records, to me, and then the total scheme of the universe, football or the coaching records don't seem all that important. So it's time to emphasize the other things in life, you know.
Mike doing any scouting for you?
Junior? Yeah, he's been watching some film.
I gotta get over and see him sometime. How's he doing?
He's still stinging.
I'll bet.
Now, sometimes you get to the point you just feel you can't be beaten. Confidence is good, but there's a fine line where you go over the edge. You never know until you face real adversity about your true chemistry.
Now this could be one of the greatest wins ever. What has been your goal? Most of you go back and get out your goal sheets. What's your goal there, Mitski? To get back to where? Back to Hershey.
And yeah, this just might be Pichotti territory. Here he is. Back
will
take over on the
32-yard
line.
Hey, Pichotti, you got a hold on the damn ball. It all starts with the damn fumble.
Wilson trying to find... Oh, it's a pass into the end zone. Everybody fooled on the play. Touchdown, Hawks!
And for the first time all year, CB West trails in a football game.
Second and one. He's got the first down, and he rumbles quickly to the outside.
Look at a little extracurricular activity from Mario D'Angelo. This Hawk team is not at all CB West.
Hey, Borda going high. He loses the football. It is picked up. And look out, here comes a rumble with Angelo Pelina. Oh yeah, here come the Bucks in the end zone. Touchdown, CB West. Here's the punt, Scipio back to the 9-yard line. Look at him lose people. Still on his feet, he could go for it.
We're firing the beat gap! The next play!
Yeah, that picture pretty indicative of the way this first half is going. You know, Bethlehem Catholic is taking it to CB West right now.
How bad you guys want this?
All right, first of all, I look around the locker room. I see a dead locker room. I see a lack of confidence. I see guys acting like it's over. Now, I told you yesterday you might be behind. You're behind. I told you before how other West teams have responded on this very field.
And listen to the crowd go wild behind their book. Central Bucks West doesn't have to think about it. They're going to go for it. Fourth and a yard and a half for the Hawk defense to defend. Pachotti in close. He's stopped. Pulled back. And for the second time this afternoon, it looks like the Hawks will take over the football on downs. McGord takes the pitch. What's the throw? Lets it fly, but he's hit. It's up for grabs. And it's picked up. It's picked up by Ted Kenyon. And Kenyon, after the catch on the pick, makes his way to the 45-yard line. Fourth and about a yard and a half. A tremendous play coming up here.
Could State. Be the play of the game right here.
Here we go. Oriole under center, a yard and a half to go for first down. They need to get to the 32. Pichotti hit hard and stopped. And it could be the third turnover by Downs this afternoon.
All right, let's go. We're still only one down.
Stop them now. Come here. I don't want my damn season to end.
Well, you got to make plays. Watch, they're going to go play action again. They're going to try to, you know, put the stake in.
And an interception. That spelled the difference here. Here goes Wilson to the outside. And he is
behind. Need a big play on defense.
Fourth and 9.5 for the Hawks in the 30. Florida drops back under pressure. Loses the football and falls on it, but he loses it either way.
No line, so we can run it right down their throat.
Under 6 minutes to play in regulation. He stands at his 30-yard line and booms another one. A lot of air under that football. He'll be handled at the 23-yard line. For Central Bucks West.
Coach, there are thousands of high schools in this great country of ours. And when you look at the top 10 ranked high school football teams in the country, two of them will play Saturday for the Pennsylvania State.
Well,
I mean, that's heady stuff.
Well, that's neat. You know, some people are trying to make this out to be a national championship.
And you have more wasted effort than I've ever seen. You know, you should be blocking half of these things.
Hey, Gap.
Once again, do you ever look and say 4 yards in front?
You can watch the film. I was 4 yards in front.
Weekend rolls on, the main event in Quad A, nationally ranked Central Bucks West, number 3 in the country, against the number 9 team in the country.
Special run balanced, backside tackle. If he's in a beat gap, we'll trap the hell out of him.
Read it back.
Okay. Now, few players have this opportunity in their lifetime, I told you before. We never play it up, but now we're on the threshold. And maybe I'll have to shake you a little bit to realize, look what you got in front of you.
Look what you got in front of you. 3 years would be unbelievable. 45-0 versus 44-1. That's the decision you got to make today.
Come on, they're bigger, but I think they're soft. I think they're soft. You got to show them who lifts the weights.
Everybody got to do a job, starting from the first play. All right, one, two, three.
And the much anticipated quad A final is underway. You're looking at really one of the, I think, top 10 players in the United States. Ball is out. Ball is down. Who's got it? I think Erie Prep has got the first turnover of the night, and they do. And he's under heavy pressure. Down he goes. Ball is down, and Central Bucks West covers at the 28-yard line.
Pichotti's down.
I think Pichotti's hurt on the 22-yard line.
Pichotti is hurt.
This is a significant storyline in this game right here.
Hey, you're going to show them you're not a one-man team. You understand that? You are not a one-man team.
Find the ball at the 9-yard line. Saw the Carlson fumble. Coming with it, Cameron. Make that Blomgren for the touchdown.
No, the big man's gone. Then here's your chance to have an unbelievable victory. We're a team. We're a team. You understand this? Face mask! Face mask! Hey!
Drop! Leonard Walker, he's loose. Big yard and still alive at the last 25-yard line.
Looks like he's going over the
okay.
Now Carlson back. Carlson logs into the end zone. Intercepted. Can you take it back with a touchdown? Wow. Incredible play. I don't believe what I just saw. Ed Hinkle took it away, and it's a touchdown.
Keep your head up. Why didn't you knock it down? Why didn't you knock it down on fourth down? You never know, damn it.
There are just those nights that you just don't push the right buttons.
What did you get flipped around for? Shut up, damn it!
Stop.
I'll tell you what, I feel Erie Prep gaining confidence as this game goes on.
The whole arm went numb.
You take it, Pichotti's done?
I think he probably is, yeah. He's going to try. I think he just turned it and sprained it.
Where's Elsie?
Drink up!
Where's Elsie? Why would you line up in the backfield with two other backs? Don't you know any football?
They told him they came in.
Get out! Stop making excuses!
Alright, when's the last time I played that position?
There's only, you got to have seven guys on the line. There were six guys on the line.
All right.
And somebody help him in there? Will you help the guy? Well then, stop making the penalties.
Guys, come on.
But like in any panic game, if somebody gets a panic attack, you know, I think your mind can stop it. You get control and you just say, hey, I'm not going to let this happen. And, you know, you just will the situation to stop.
Let's go. That's it. Coach, it's my turn. I want to see your heads up. Why is anybody looking at the floor? Can't we win without Dustin?
Yeah.
Things mean more when you get it through adversity. Now, you are still the team that has pumped weights forever. We better own the second half. You know they don't work like we work. All right, now do you want it?
Yeah!
Do you want it?
Yeah!
Let's go.
Let's go. Yeah.
would have been a great victory if we could do it as it was. But now, with Dustin out, it would be more unbelievable if you do it.
Third down. They need some help, I'm telling you. They need some help.
Center, this is DeMond Sanders. Big hole to the outside of the 10-5. Here he preps on the lead. Touchdown.
Let's go, guys. We better come back.
Kicking into the teeth of the wind. High snap. Kick up. No good. It's short.
All right, you're going to give up or what?
No.
One time.
And now Cameron's hurt, and keep in mind he's been suffering from shin splints. This will be DiGiacomo trying to get outside. I don't think so.
And DiGiacomo reaching for his right leg as he's trying to get up, but you'll see it here.
We got another guy hurt.
Yo, what is Junior calling down? What is Junior liking up there?
Flip the mat. Flip the mat, son.
Flip the who?
Mat.
There's nobody to flip to yet. All the running backs are dead.
I'm not saying to joke, Dusty. This is for all the wrong. You've never played hurt before.
Dude, I can't walk on my camera. Jog my. You gotta
run. Plus, I don't have any running backs.
See, another thing. He doesn't know his plays, and he tells you he knows his plays.
You don't know your plays.
Oh, now it's most of them.
I don't get reps, so how am I supposed to?
Oh, now it's it. Didn't I tell you at the beginning of the year some guys wouldn't get reps? But the guys that still can do that and play.
This guy's ready.
You ready? All right, wing right, 57 quick pitch. Wing right, 57.
Saw game big haul, Bob Warden's first carry. Here's Warden, who's been great in this fourth quarter, bounces off, has the first down. To get a first, Oriel back, looks, throws, got a man wide open, it's caught. This is caught on him, and he's got it all the way down to the 23-yard line. This is Hutton. That's only his fourth count, and he's inside the 10 and slams it all the way to the 6-yard line. Oriel's out of keeper, trying to find some room. Nothing there. He's out at the 9. Let's tip, and it's going to be fourth down now. Watch out. And they've got him, and he's sacked all the way back. Joe Dupree is there.
Never had a chance.
And say, hey, lost the last game, I can't go out like this, you know. Hey, that would be insane.
Stop him right now. This is it. No first downs.
Get up.
Now the Central Bucks defense coming up.
And get your punt block ready.
Five-second clock. Carlson back. Throws. Ball is held. It's up into the air. Where did it go? And I'll tell you what, Ed Hinkle is going to make the most important punt of his life coming up here. Over. This is really a moment of truth.
Go after the punt. Elson, lock it.
They locked it! It's blocked! Nebraska, the gold medal for the third consecutive year.
That's unbelievable.
That is the great offense.
What happened to guys?
TV West, follow
You were the greatest.
It was super.
That's a hell of a way to go out. That's a hell of a way to go out. I got to hope the Bucks won. The Bucks won.
That's the greatest victory ever.
Things I can think back of a career, and it was the titles and championships are great. The relationships I've had are priceless. Anything I've given, I've gotten back.
Roman emperors, we gotta get killed.